Hi folks, welcome back. I hope you're all doing well. One of the perennial debates in large language models has been whether to prefer fine-tuning or retrieval augmented generation when trying to specialize an LLM to a very specific domain. There have been plenty of arguments both ways. People have had hunches and conjectures, but this paper is one of the first to actually quantitatively look at the effectiveness of each of those techniques. The problem we're trying to solve is one of the very basic problems when using LLMs, which is that you want to use it for some very specialized domain or with current events that are past the knowledge cutoff date of the corpus that was used to train the model. And so the question is, how do you add this new knowledge or specialized knowledge for a very specific domain to the LLM? And there have been two main techniques to add this new knowledge to an LLM. The first one is fine-tuning. You can think of fine-tuning as essentially continuing the pre-training process, but with task or topic-specific data. So if you want to train an LLM for, say, chemistry, you would bring a whole lot of new chemistry-specific data and continue training the LLM on that data. And what you have at the end of fine-tuning is a new updated LLM whose weights have been changed and updated specific to that domain. The other big class of techniques is called in-context learning, and the now familiar RAG or retrieval augmented generation is the main technique within that class. The way RAG or in-context learning works is that you don't really change your pre-trained model, but you provide it additional domain-specific or query-specific context that the model can then use to synthesize its answer. Now, before we get into comparing these two techniques, we should try to understand what causes an LLM to make factual errors or to hallucinate. And there are several causes. The first most obvious one is that the LLM simply did not have any knowledge about that domain. So it never saw that topic in its training corpus. The second one, of course, is simply old information. LLMs are trained with a corpus that is up to date only to a certain date, and it simply doesn't know things that happened after that date. You can also have an LLM not remember facts that it has seen very rarely in its training corpus. Now, here's an interesting category of errors. In what is called catastrophic forgetting, we find that when you do fine-tuning on a model, that might actually make it forget knowledge from its pre-trained corpus. I recently read a paper that talks about this phenomena in more detail, so stay tuned for that paper. And lastly, the LLM might have the knowledge, but it might not make the correct inferences or connections between the pieces of knowledge that it already has. So that is a reasoning failure. All right, so let's look at how the authors constructed their experiment. To construct the data set that was used for fine-tuning, they took the MMLU benchmark. By the way, I have a video explaining that benchmark. I'll link it below. And looked within that benchmark at a few specific topics: anatomy, astronomy, biology, chemistry, and prehistory. So that's one data set for fine-tuning. The other data set they used was information about current events. So they picked multiple choice questions about events that happened after the cutoff date of the models that they were testing. And they focused on current events from the USA in the time span of August to November 2023. And they took that data from Wikipedia. And the models they tested on were several open source small models. So they have Mistral 7B, Llama 2 7B, Orca 2 7B. And they tested it with both zero-shot and five-shot prompts. And here you can see them comparing the accuracy of each technique. So we have the base model, we have the base model plus RAG, a fine-tuned model, and a combination of fine-tuned and RAG together. And you can see here that RAG almost always wins out. There are cases when combining fine-tuning and RAG either draws with simply base model plus RAG or improves over RAG very slightly. But if you look at the results for the current events test, you can see that RAG handily beats fine-tuning. This diagram is another way to visualize those results. It shows you the accuracy gain for each of these different methods. And here you can see that for all the models tested, the accuracy gain for RAG, which is the second column, is much larger than the accuracy gain for simply fine-tuning, which is this first column. Fine-tuning did help, but RAG helped much more. So why is that though? Why does RAG perform so much better than fine-tuning? The authors here are hypothesizing that one of the key properties of RAG is that it adds a lot of context that is query-specific, and fine-tuning doesn't do that. Fine-tuning is independent of the specific query that was posed to the LLM. The other downside of fine-tuning is that, as we saw before, it suffers from catastrophic forgetting, which means that sometimes fine-tuning can make the LLM forget things from its pre-trained data set. So the experiments in this paper quite conclusively show that RAG outperforms fine-tuning. The big caveat to the claim is that the models tested in this paper were some pretty small open source models, 7B models. Now, whether this pattern holds for much larger models like GPT-4 is still an open question. With GPT-4, the model is so large that it already has very high accuracy on MMLU. So there's not much room left for improvement. So that was a quick look at a paper that compared RAG and fine-tuning, showed RAG handily beating fine-tuning, at least on the models that they tested. And it's one of the first papers I've seen that quantitatively tries to answer that question of which technique is better for adding domain-specific knowledge to an LLM. I hope you enjoyed that. If you like content like this, please like the video, consider subscribing, and I will see you all next time. Thank you very much.